Well, here we are back at Twigmoor Wood. Going to have a go at painting a 20-30 canvas. Where we went last time, just over to the left in there. And it's just so gorgeous. There's a little bit of sunlight which we're going to need. We're going to go just through this entrance here. Look at these lovely reds and mauves. A bit further yet. And this is where I want to go and paint, just down here. Rhododendrons are coming to their end, I see. Almost done. Another week and they'll be too late. So what have we got? So gorgeous, isn't it? What do we do, dog? Pity those are just going. This. It's a lot of detail, but it could be fun today. Drawing worked out, but that isn't easy. It's a very complicated composition that I've taken on. As I said, the flowers are right at the end as well. I'm not sure that I'm doing the best thing here at all, but my composition. Well, this will be a bit painting, I guess. One of you was recently asking if I could get in closer to the canvas and show you more of the palette and brushwork, but on my own, I simply can't do it. I can manage to film with one camera, sometimes two, but out here to manage more. I need somebody else filming to do this, and then it would work. But there's my palette of paints anyway, ready to go. So let's share what I'm going to do with you as much as I can. I'm going to take a large brush to start with, half inch in this case, that's a huge one. We haven't got a huge candle. At least you'll be able to see the whole thing this time. And we'll look at these colours straight away above. To get this light in, I'm going to push colours immediately. And change one colour to another already and start to compare straight away, just the blocks of colour. I don't want to go straight to detail, I want to block in some of these colours and just find them coming through here. And obviously one colour is comparative to another, so that's what I've got to work out. At the moment is just what comparative colours. Let's just get some nice light colour straight in here. and gradually work from loose to tight, which is what you wanted to know, I think. You were asking about my techniques and how I work. Well, you can see it here. Should be close enough up to actually see the brush strokes this time. Good luck. Slight differences between these colours. The colour hues can be so small. Not too much wind today, so you should be able to hear what I'm saying as well. Compare one tone to another and one colour hue to another. Very rapid working up the lights and darks. Straight away. No time to waste. Isn't time to waste. Start to establish the smaller details as quickly. Blues and the greys in up there, yeah? Just beginning. So much to do. Just got to get the painting well established at this stage. Your colour, so we can get it shadowed there. Beautiful colours sort of hiding away in these bushes. Thank you. see the texture I'm leaving of the paint underneath as I'm going through here. I'm going to be painting every single little bit of flower in, that's for sure. Just get the basics. The feeling of the thing. Solid heavy body paint, we can plough into the picture. Get a little bit of texture working by dry brush. So I'm not going to be able to paint all of the leaves in. I'm not going for that. Almost covered the white surface to be able to get. Fairly crude at the moment. It's that sky doing up there. It's got a lovely pale blue to it with the creams. It's got bits of sky going on up here.
Today.
Oh God, yes, we're just disappearing. This is about our last week, I think, for the drop.
Yeah.
And I did one here the other week, and this lot, this is what I was going to paint, but they're almost dead now.
Yeah.
So I've got another week or so just to working amongst them, I think.
Yeah.
I was just saying, a long left to paint all this lot. So. Right, that's just about got rid of my whites, so I'm able to see what I've got here a bit more now. The weather's going to do. It feels a bit rainy, but I'm hoping we're going to get away with it. Going on back there. Into the tree here. Really up for these colours today. Starting to pick up on a few of the individual feelings of the leaves. Make the marks about what you're painting. You can't paint exactly. Haven't got time for that today, just to make an impression of it. Gradually tighten up as I go along. Get to the sky again. I do want lighter back in that sky. Decided what I'm going to do it yet. Try very, very light orange. Yes, more of a light green into orange actually. established, like I said. And they're going right back over there to the distance, either side of the pond there. It's got this cacophony of colour, beautiful colours that are coming up here. These silly dogs, aren't they? Yes. Comparing these colours back here. You can watch these blues as well, so the brighter colours up in the sky. Very impressionist piece, yes. As an aggressive build up, I guess we'll put it together, I think. Really bright orange, red, to glow in here. We've painted things a few times, start to get a feel for it. I'm just starting to find my way with this subject. and loose, and we're now just tightening up at the end. You stop looking after a while, you think you've got it there because you've got marks in approximate places, but you've got to go back and then look again to make sure everything is balancing. The colours are getting a bit too close to the end, a bit too dirty with it.
Fantastic one.
You seen it?
Yeah. Oh wow.
A bit more detailed this time.
Oh, they're so colourful though.
It's almost, you see, I've only got a few days left, haven't I? Because I'll try and get down tomorrow again.
Do you keep them or do you sell them?
I'll sell them, yeah.
Absolutely wonderful. Yeah. How much would you get for a piece like that?
Won't you?
Depends on what I'm saying to
you. Right.
The gallery's put 50% on.
Right.
If I sell privately, I got 50% off straight away.
Yeah.
I'll give you a card, you can have a look at what I do.
Oh, brilliant, yeah, because I'd love to have one of them in my living room, to be honest. I'd absolutely love it. Thank you.
All right.
I just love the colours on them, they're so colourful.
I really push colour, yeah, because I'm an impressionist, you see, so
yeah.
You can see from the palette.
Yeah.
It's like a box of sweets, isn't it?
Just wonderful, right. Absolutely wonderful. You do a really good job.
Well, I do smaller ones cheaper. I do pastels as well, and pastels are cheaper because you've got to frame them yourself.
Ah, okay.
There's as much work in watercolours and pastels.
So do you have most of your...
It's all on the website.
Right, okay, yeah. I'll have a look at that when I go home. Thank you.
Oh, it's not as loose as I would have liked to have kept it, but
gosh, that's beautiful.
Thanks.
Amazing. Have you been here all day?
Just a couple of hours. But the paints just go their own way. It's getting late now with the flowers. I've only got a few more days to do a couple more.
Yeah.
I wanted to do this field, but all this has died off, unfortunately. So. I started very loose and I've gradually tightened up. I don't want to go too tight.
Beautiful.
Thanks.
When did you start doing it?
Oh, let's see. It is about 3 hours, 2.5, 3 hours now. You can see all the work there.
I love the... Are they lily? What sort of flowers are the ones in there?
The yellow ones?
Yeah.
Flag iris.
Yeah. I love flowers though.
Ah, yes. Especially one of these. The colour of these is fantastic, that's right.
Lovely dog as well.
Oh, she's very quiet, long as she stays there.
How old is she?
She's 8 now, so she's coming 8, 9. Yeah, she's coming, getting older.
Oh,
she's very,
well,
very
14,
good gander.
So...
So we'll sign that at that, I think, and call it a day. Call it a painting, actually, but it's a nice light. I think we've got that half evening light of today. It isn't bright sunlight anymore, anyway. Well, hopefully you've been able to see that one being done well enough. Split onto a white canvas, direct painting, just building up loosely and then going tighter and tighter until we get this late afternoon, early evening light, soft light. Here's a good girl. Finished somewhere. Well, there we are. That one's completed. I wasn't sure where it was going to go. I was a bit wary of this one because I went too detailed last time. I've almost gone there this time, but there's just so much going on in it. But I wanted to paint this one before the flowers totally went with these flag iris in, which would be very difficult with the yellows. So it's been a struggle, but I think we've got a nice coherent little painting now. Lovely spot to be, but we'll only get one more chance, I think. I'll be coming back tomorrow, so I've got to decide where I'm going to go. There's some nice colours here, but whether I can get them all in, I don't know. There's a composition here. Maybe something like that, or maybe even a bit closer in like that would be good. Lovely pinks here. I think I need to come in closer, something like this. Even though I can't do all those lovely colours in that way. Light's wrong from here.